In the lecture about selecting hair, we've already seen a blending mode in action. When you give a layer a blending mode, you will be able to look through that layer without lowering the opacity of that layer. So a blending mode is like a filter. It will let some information through, for example all the light colors from beneath, and at the same time blocks other information, for example all the dark colors from beneath. For this reason, blending modes are very powerful and will give results that are not possible to get in another way. Blending modes can roughly be categorized in four groups. Blending modes that make underlying layers lighter, blending modes that make underlying layers darker, blending modes that give underlying layers more contrast, and blending modes that change the color of the layers below. In three lectures, the most used blending modes will be discussed. To see a blending mode in action, we need two layers or more. The blending mode will be applied to the top layer. The layer or layers under it are the ones that the top layer will interact with. I have opened mountains and stars. In the mountain image, I would like to have some stars in the sky. I will borrow the stars from the stars image. I drag the stars image on the mountains image. I go to Mode and choose the Lighten Only blending mode. Now I have stars in the sky. So how does Lighten Only work? The Lighten Only blending mode makes a comparison. Which layer has the lightest color? Is it a layer with the blending mode or a layer below it? For each pixel, this comparison is made. The lightest pixel wins and will be shown. I only want the stars, so I will remove the light mountains at the bottom using a layer mask. I right-click on the stars layer and choose Add Layer Mask. I choose a white mask and I press Enter. To hide the mountains, I will paint with black. I press B to select the brush, and in the tool options I choose a hard brush. I increase the size to about 400. Now I paint away the light mountains. If I hide and show the top layer, I see only the stars are now added. I will lower the opacity a bit to get a more subtle effect. Now we will look at the opposite of lighten only, darken only. We have already seen this blending mode in action in the lecture about selecting hair. I have opened Amsterdam, clouds and birds. I would like to place some clouds in the sky. I drag the clouds image over and drag the clouds a bit up. Now I go to Mode and choose Darken Only. With Darken Only, only the darkest pixels will be shown. That's why I see the clouds. The clouds are darker than the bright sky. Under the sky, I see the buildings, because the buildings are darker than the clouds. Let's optimize the result a bit. To prevent that the clouds interact with the buildings, I will make a selection of the sky. I hide the top layer and select the bottom layer. I click on the fuzzy select tool. Now I click in the lightest area in the sky and drag the threshold to about 120. Now that I have a selection, I right-click on the top layer and choose Add Layer Mask. I click on Selection and press Enter. I press Ctrl-D to deselect and click on the eye. I can still see a bit of white in the trees. To reveal the sky in the trees, I select my brush and set the size to about 60. I press X to reverse black to white. I paint in my layer mask to reveal the sky. I will now create a new layer from what is visible at this moment, like a snapshot. I do this by right-clicking on the top layer and choose New from Visible. I have now added a flattened version of my document in one layer. I will brighten this new layer. I press Ctrl-L to open Levels and drag the middle slider to the left. I would also like to put some birds in the sky. I drag birds over and move them up in the sky. I want to see the birds and hide the gray. I will start by setting the layer to darken only. Because almost everything on the birds layer is darker than the sky underneath, only the birds layer is visible. To change this, I open Levels. I will brighten the image with the mid-tone slider until the gray background gets lighter than the sky beneath. Now only the birds are darker than the background. Now we will look at Screen and Multiply. Like Lighten and Darken only, Screen and Multiply are opposites. I drag the girl image over. I will place the girl layer partially over the dark mountains. If I set the girl layer on Lighten only, I will see only the lightest pixels, which means only part of the girl image and only part of the mountains image. But what if I want to see both images completely? Under Lighten only, I select Screen. Screen can be compared to using two separate slide projectors who are both projecting on the same screen. One projector shows the mountains and the other projector shows the girl. The images overlap, so we get a slightly lighter result, but both images are now visible, which is what we want. Now let's look at a practical example for screen and go to lens flare. I would like to add this lens flare to the girl image to give it a sunny effect. I drag it over. For adding the stars, we used Lighten only. If we use Lighten only for the lens flare, we see we are not getting the result we are looking for. This is because there is no real blending going on. The way to get the actual light from the flare is to use the double slide projector technique provided by the screen mode. Screen can also be used to lighten the image itself. I hide the flare and make a duplicate of the girl. I set the duplicate on screen. With opacity, I can lower the light from the second projector. The opposite of screen is multiply. For screen, we had the comparison of having two projectors. With multiply, we are back to one projector, showing both images at the same time. You could compare it to a light table, where you lay two transparent sheets on top of each other. The second sheet will make the result darker. Let's have a look. I have opened Rails. Let's say I want an orange circle and I want to see the background through the orange circle. For this, we will need the light table effect. I create a new layer. To draw a circle, I select the Ellipse Select tool. I start dragging and then I add the Shift key. To adjust its size, I drag a corner or side and add the Shift key. To position the circle, I drag in the middle of the circle. Now I open the color panel and select orange. I fill the selection by pressing Alt Backspace. I press Ctrl D to deselect. In the Layers panel, I choose Multiply. Under Multiply, we have Burn. I have opened Building. Burn is a variation of Multiply and gives a more dramatic effect. It gives more contrast and saturation, providing a cinematic look. In the next lecture, we will look at the contrast group.